Hey guys, you're Martin. Again, this video I'm going to share with you guys my review of the Samsung Galaxy Note 5 after 2 weeks of personal usage. Let's go ahead and get started. So first of all, I want to talk about the things that I really, really like about the Samsung Galaxy Note 5, and it has to be the design. The design of this phone is just incredible. In my opinion, Samsung has created the best design ever on any phone that they ever created. This phone just feels very awesome in my hands. It's a 5.7-inch screen, which a lot of people consider it huge. But besides that, it just feels very, very awesome. This time around, they put metal in the sides. Yes, just like the Galaxy Note 4 had metal in the sides. But this metal here surrounding this phone feels a lot more smoother than the Galaxy Note 4 did. Rounded as well. So rounded that it matches very good with the glass back, which is also curved. Of course, this comes in different colors. This is the white, of course, but it comes in black, which looks a little bit like blue. I think it comes in silver as well. I haven't seen it yet. Another thing that I love about the design is the bezels. Look how thin are those bezels. That combined with the way that this phone is curved, it just feels awesome in your hand. It feels natural. You're not doing so much effort to hold this phone because it just feels right. The other thing that I love about the Samsung Galaxy S5 is a feature that I couldn't use in the last model, the fingerprint scanner. Yes, the fingerprint scanner was available on the Galaxy Note 4, but it was not nearly as fast as it is here on the Galaxy Note 5. Look at that. Look how fast it worked from the screen being off to the screen being unlocked. And thanks to that, I am finally using a phone with security, because I am one of those guys that I hate using codes. I hate using the patterns. I always use the sliding feature to unlock my phones. And thanks to this feature, I just love it that I can just use the fingerprint scanner, and it works very good because you can apply, I think up to four fingers. You can apply the fingerprint scanner up to four fingers and it will be compatible. And it's very good. It's very consistent. I've been having no problem whatsoever when it comes to using the fingerprint scanner. And I just want to take it a little step further with the Samsung Pay. I can't wait to use Samsung Pay just because of the fingerprint scanner. I think it's going to be a lot more easier than it was before. I used to use a Google Wallet, and yes, it works good, but I think the Samsung Pay is going to work a lot more better, and that combined with the fingerprint scanner, I just can't wait to use it. Of course, the other thing that I love about the Samsung Galaxy Note 5 is the screen. It has a 5.7 Super AMOLED screen, which is QHD 2560 by 1440. The colors here on the screen just looks gorgeous. Everything that you see here, gameplay, videos, anything that you see on the screen of this phone just looks gorgeous. All the colors pop up. That's no surprise there, because Samsung always does amazing screens when it comes to every little iteration of every phone. When it comes to Galaxy S devices and Galaxy Note devices, they always step it up. They always bring their game A game. And here on the Galaxy Note 5, it is no different. They just brought it. Colors looks amazing. The screen looks gorgeous. You know, the size for me, it's a perfect size. I can do multitasking on the screen with no problem whatsoever, and it's just gorgeous. I can't complain about how this phone looks at all. So definitely the display is one of the high points of this phone as well. Just like the Super AMOLED screen, there's another feature where Samsung always exceeds, and it's the camera. This time around, they did an awesome job with the camera. I like the fact that it launches very, very fast. It doesn't matter where you at. When you double tap the home button, it will automatically launch the camera. They did an amazing job here with the camera. The colors, they look just gorgeous on this camera when it comes to photo, when it comes to videos. The videos, you can record up to 4K video, 2K video, 1080p video with 60 frames frames per second and the normal 1080p screen and a little bit lower if you want. The camera in the rear is a 16 megapixel camera, which takes amazing, beautiful pictures. The front camera is a 5 megapixel, which also takes great pictures and also very wide as well. That way you can fit everybody in your screen. It feels very good. I like the fact that they added auto HDR this time around, because before they used to have only HDR on or HDR off. This time around they added the auto HDR, which I really like. It for me is very, very convenient. When it comes to modes, they added a couple modes, but they took away other modes as well, and it's very good because of course they added the pro mode, which is basically a manual mode for those that like to control all their settings manually. So you now have the pro mode. You also have a live broadcast, which lets you broadcast to your YouTube account live. I still haven't been able to try that yet because I'm having problems linking my account, but as soon as I get to use it, I'll go ahead and do it. I have the slow motion, the fast motion, the virtual shot, the panorama. It doesn't matter what you do in this video, especially the video collage. Even the video collage new feature actually looks cool as well, and I took a couple pictures as well. And the camera, just like always, I'm telling you guys, just like always, they always bring their A game. They're always, the Galaxy Note 4 was better than the Note 3, and here the Note 5 is better than the Note 4. And of course, the performance of this phone is just amazing as well. It's blazing fast. I have nothing to complain about the performance of this phone. This phone has, this time around, a Exynos CPU, which is an octa-core CPU. It is combined by a quad-core 1.5 gigahertz and a quad core 2.1 gigahertz. And this phone just feels very, very fast. I don't have any problem whatsoever when it comes to playing video games. I could play for a lot of time and the phone does not get laggy at all, which is a feature that which is a symptom that I used to suffer before in other phones after playing a lot on the phone. This phone feels a lot more smoother when it comes to play video games. Of course, it also has 4 gigabytes of RAM, which it has to be a big difference there as well. TouchWiz this time around is a lot more lighter as well. If you use a TouchWiz before, yes, it's going to look similar to when it comes to the coloring and all that, and when it comes to the, you know, the way icons looks and all that, it's going to look a little bit similar, but you're going to notice right away when you start using this phone that TouchWiz feels a lot more lighter, and it's because it is a lot more lighter than before. Another cool feature that this phone has, besides fast charging, which was available on the Galaxy Note 4, is the wireless charging. It comes integrated with the phone. You don't have to buy any other accessory. The only accessory you actually need is a power mat or a power base to charge the phone. And it's compatible with power mats. It's compatible with Qi charging technology. So that's great that you don't have to get out of your way and buy a Samsung exclusive charging mat. This right here is a generic charging pad. And like you see there, it works perfectly good. Look at that, turns right away and starts charging. Of course, the awesome thing about this phone is the S Pen. That's the reason you buy a Galaxy Note device. It's the S Pen, and they did a lot of great stuff here with the S Pen. Like for example, when the phone is off or in standby and you take off the pen, like you see there, you can start writing here in the lock screen, and it is awesome. I like it very much. They did a lot of great stuff here. Let's go and discard that. When it comes to the air command, they also added a nice looking air command here, which now lets you do action memo, smart select, screen write, and now you have the option to add 3 more shortcuts, which is awesome because you can add apps that you like. For example, I put S Note, Evernote, and a calculator there, which I can have fast access anytime that I'm using this, because I use the calculator when I'm doing notes, depending what type of notes I'm doing. I am a heavy S Note user, so that's why I love the Galaxy Note devices. Like you see here, these are notes that I've been taking for a long time on my other devices, because I use Evernote to sync my notes from Note 4 to Note 5. So when I'm brainstorming on how to create a video and all that, I'm always using S Note. I use the S Note a lot. I'm one of those that even actually have to change the tip of the S Pen, because sometimes it gets all worn out after a year of using it. So yes, the S Pen for me, I love all the changes they did. It looks awesome as well. And now it has this clicky mechanic here on the top. Sound and feel like a real pen, but of course this is useless. This ain't doing nothing for your job or anything else. It's just there to prop the, you know, the S Pen out of the device, just like that. That's the only reason that's there for. And of course you have that mechanic at the same time. But I love all the changes they did to S Pen, and I love what they've done with the other features like Air Command and all that. So yes, the S Pen for me, I just love it better than the Galaxy Note 4. Now let's talk about the things I do not like about the Samsung Galaxy Note 5, and new users coming to the Note 5 should know before they buy. And it's one, you cannot add more storage. You cannot add a micro SD card like you used to be able to on other devices like the Note 4, Note 3, Note 2, Note 1, you name it. You cannot add a micro SD card. And I think that really sucks, because when it comes to the purchase, you have to decide whether to get the 32 version, which is going to be the cheaper version, or the 64 gigabytes. This is the 64 gigabytes because I know that I use a lot of space. I do a lot of podcasting. I do a lot of videos. I do a lot of gaming. So 64 gigabytes for me is the space that you have to get. But prior than that, I used to buy just the cheapest model and add a micro SD card. And I know a lot of people do that too, and they're going to be disappointed. Yes, there's people that say, well, you wanted a great design, you wanted a beautiful design, now the Samsung gave it to you, now you're complaining, blah, 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 blah. Well, that's BS, because there's a lot of great devices in the market from other companies that have, you know, awesome design with metal or glass, and you can still add a micro SD card from the side or from the same tray that the SIM card is at. You could have either put two the micro SIM card, the SIM card, and the micro SD card. You could have done other things to add a memory card to this phone. Just because the back is not removable, it doesn't mean you could not add it to the phone. Another thing that I don't like about this phone is that the battery, not only is it not removable, which I don't really care, I could live without that, but the battery is smaller. The battery is a 3000 milliampere hour battery. The Galaxy Note 4 was a 3220 milliampere hour battery. And the battery life, when it comes to battery life, I don't see this phone having great battery life. I've been having I've been having an average battery life. If I use the phone like I normally use it, like with do podcasting and play some video games here and there, I'm getting around 8 hours of battery life. If I'm just like reading emails or doing Flipboard and not watching videos and all that, I can get over 10 hours of battery life. I find it that the Galaxy Note 4 had more battery life than the Galaxy Note 5. And remember, this is a new device out of the box, 2 weeks old. This is an old device. This is already a 1 year old device. And for me, the batteries are equal right now. Other negative thing that I have to mention, I was not going to mention in my video, but I have to mention it, is that I honestly believe there is a design flaw when it comes to the S Pen. When this first got into the media, when it first got into the news, I was like, why would people put their S Pen backwards? It makes no sense, right? I never had problems putting my S Pen backwards on any of my Galaxy Note phone devices before. But I started to think like a parent, and I've seen a lot of parents give their phones to the kids, right? And so they can play with the phones, right? And I've seen a lot of kids play with the phones. And I've seen kids play with old Galaxy Note devices when I go to a doctor's appointment or to a mechanic to fix my car, and I'm waiting in the waiting room. I see kids with Galaxy Note devices in their hand playing with the pen, and thinking about that, I got the message there. Thinking about that, considering that could be a problem, I think that makes it a design flaw. Like I said, I personally do not have a problem with the S Pen. I am not going to be putting the S Pen backwards. If you put it, for those that do not know what I'm talking about, this pen can easily go the wrong way into the phone. When it goes all the way in, this part right here gets stuck inside the phone, and the phone and this pen will not come out easily. And sometimes it comes out and it damages the sensors from this pen. Like you saw there, we got a pop-up saying that, hey, your pen is not in the phone. Well, if that happened, it would damage that sensor. You will not get that message. You would also not get feedback like the air command. When you take out the pen, the air command wouldn't work. You would have to activate it yourself. For me, like I said, I don't have a problem with this design. I love the design of the S Pen. I love what Samsung did with the design of the phone. But I have to admit that it is a design flaw, because there should be no reason. It should not be easy for me to put the S Pen the wrong way. It should not be easy. And it is easy. And if you're one of those that like giving your phones to your kids, that might be a problem for you. It is a scary situation, because your kid can damage your $800 phone just by putting the S Pen the wrong way. So don't do it. Don't give this phone to a kid. Okay, guys, and that's it with my review. Those are all the great things that I love about the Samsung Galaxy Note 5 and the things that I do not like about the Galaxy Note 5. And I have to say, as my closing comment, is that this right here is, for me, the best phone that I've ever had, best design that I've ever touched, when it comes even compared to iPhones, because I consider iPhones always having a great, awesome device when you have it in your hand and it looks great and all that. This phone just trumps that. For me, this phone just looks super incredible when it comes to the design wise, when it comes to the camera, when it comes to the screen. For me, I've never seen a phone that looks better and feels than this. Another thing, when it comes to big phones, in the market, there's a lot of people, there's a lot of companies making phablets. But when it comes to this phone, you know, there's no phone that can stand up to it, especially because they have an awesome S Pen. This is the fifth generation of the Galaxy Note devices, the fifth generation of the S Pen. And that combination right there, this puts the phone on top of the mountain. This is, for me, the best big phone you can buy in the market. And there's a lot, like I said, there's a lot of phablets, a lot of big phone, no matter how you want to call it. But guess what? They're all just big phones. That's it. This phone is big, and it's big for a reason. It's big to be the best multitasking device, and it's big to be the best productivity device. And that's what I love about the Galaxy Note 5. So guys, that's it. Thanks for watching my video. Thanks for watching my reviews. Keep in mind, there's going to be a lot more Galaxy Note videos coming up to my channel. Let me know what you think about my review. Let me know what you think about the Galaxy Note 5 as well. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Till next time.